Hey guys and girls, welcome back to my channel. Thank you for joining me for this video. Now, this does look like a previous video. Yes, I'm filming two videos in one day and I can't bother to change my top. So we are going to be reviewing, as you can see from the title, REM Beauty. So Ariana Grande's makeup brand. They did kindly send me over a box full of makeup from her brand. So I have seen a lot of controversy on this. Some people love it, some people hate it. I wanted to give you my thoughts on it. I'm not that you asked for it, but yeah, so if you want to see what my thoughts are and create a look with me, then please keep on watching. So we're going to start off with the eyes, to be honest. I just want to get straight into this. So this is the packaging of all of her products, REM Beauty anyway. I actually kind of like it. I know a lot of people are giving a lot of hate to it, but I guess to each to their own. The eyeshadow palettes, I believe, retail for $24. This is the packaging. I actually kind of like it. It's actually kind of like different. This is what the palette looks like. Now I have the shade Baby Doll, which I'm really glad about because I know this is probably going to be one of the most popular. These are the swatches of the eyeshadow palette, the Baby Doll one. Now they did have a lovely creamy velvety texture. They were a little bit there was a little bit of fallout, but there was nothing to complain about, and the shimmers actually look really lovely. However, I have heard they are very minimal on the eyes, so let's try that, and we're going to go in with the eyeshadow palette. So beginning with the palette, I'm going to take that white shade, or like base tone shade. This is really, really pigmented, but it did have a little bit of fallout. Then I'm going to take that brown shade. It's like a transitional shade, but it's so lovely. I didn't have any blending issues whatsoever. Then I'm going to take the last two deeper shades and sort of blend them out on the outer corner, and then focusing that white shade once again in the inner corner because it's extremely pigmented. Oh my God, look at how pigmented that is. I love it. And I also took it on my waterline. It actually fits really, really lovely in the waterline. Then I took the shimmer. Now the shimmers weren't amazing, so that's why I directed them in the inner corner, because I knew I would be slightly disappointed if I put them on the lid. Now this liner, oh my God, it's so black, it's everything. It look at how easy it was for me to do my liner. I normally struggle, but I got the perfect liner. It wasn't too thick, it wasn't too thin. I love this. Oh my God, I'm obsessed with my liner today, and I never really wear a liner. Now moving on to the mascara. Now I won't lie to you, this is a bit of a miss for me. The brush wand is actually very, very comfortable, but I do like it on my lower lashes rather than my top lashes. Moving on to the lashes, these are so cute. They're very comfortable. I love the band, and this is the eye look that we have going on. I am completely in love.
So these are the eyes. I am actually really in love. Like, really in love. There are a few hit and misses about the products, but I thought I'd just give you my quick thoughts because we did just do a voiceover on the tutorial. So the eyeshadow palette, I would give it a 7 out of 10 personally. I feel as if they could have done a lot better with this. They could have included a black. However, I don't think it actually needs it in this palette. I think it's actually really, really nice. The swatches came out quite nice, but the pigmentation, it's on point. It's like it doesn't need to go any more than what it needs to. There's fallout on the palette, but there's no fallout on the eyes. This white shade right here is stunning. It's not right, it's more of like a cream base kind of tone. It's stunning. It really brightens up the eyes. Browns are lovely. This brown right here is really stunning. It just blends on really, really easily. My eyes just have this really velvety finish currently, and I'm like completely obsessed with it. I feel as if the shimmers though, the shimmers were a huge letdown. The shimmers for me were just, I think on camera they just add that just correct amount of shimmer. There could have been like a icy shimmer, I think, or like a champagne-y kind of color that would have like being the icing on the cake for this palette. I wouldn't say this is like a mastery palette, like, oh my God, you need it. But I feel as if you love Ariana Grande and it's very much, you're very not much into makeup, but you want to try something, this might be it. And I think for $24, I believe it retailed at, was it 24? It's not too bad. There's something I'm even more obsessed with. Now, this is something you bloody need. I am not an eyeliner girl. I'm not an eyeliner girl at all. Ariana Grande has made me an eyeliner girl. Oh, one more thing to quote about that palette. Now, I was really looking forward and hoping that she'd have like a waterliner color. Now, you know, I can see it's ever so slightly like brighter. I actually used that shadow and it was really, really lovely in the waterline. So you can obviously, I wouldn't say, I'm not going to advise you to, but I did. And my eyes are absolutely fine. Moving on to the liner, like I said, it retails for $19. Get your hands on it. If you are a liner person, I'd seen so many TikTok videos, people saying it was really patchy, it was really drying. For me, it wasn't at all. I think from the liner tutorial that you could see, the tip is just perfect. It's so black, and it has this gorgeous finish. Now, I would have preferred it to have finished ever so slightly a little bit more matte, but I'm not complaining. This is really, really lovely. I did my liner in one go. I didn't have to clean up any part of my liner. It's giving me that really nice liner. It's not giving me too thick. It's not giving me too thin. Beautiful formula. Really, really nice formula. I think you guys can see. It's just cute. I really, really like it. So yeah, now moving on to mascara. This is the Midnight Black, I believe. Flourishing Volumizing Mascara. Now this retails for $15. I think it's more on the cheaper spectrum. And I think $15 for a mascara is not bad when you've got things like L'Oreal that retail at £9.99. So I think they're very, very similar pricing, to be honest. I really like the packaging of these also. I think it's a little bit too reflective for me. So I would have liked a little bit of a difference in them. But like, this is cute. This is cute. I'm not a fan of this personally. However, it is very, very lovely as a lower lash mascara because I find with my lower lashes, I can use normal mascaras. They go very clumpy, very, very black, very, very quickly. This one doesn't. This didn't do anything out of the ordinary for my upper lashes. So if you have your ordinary mascaras that you love and you favour, you don't need this personally unless you want something really, really nice for the lower lash line. For me, this is a miss. I personally wouldn't recommend. Like, it's not that I wouldn't recommend that it's bad. I just wouldn't recommend because it doesn't do anything for me out of the ordinary. Lashes, how can I forget? So these are $16. So not too bad of a pricing as well. I know the $16 in the UK looks quite a lot, but I don't think it is. So these are the Grow and Show lashes, I believe. These are very, very pretty. Very, very, very pretty. They're very comfortable to put on. The band is nice. I don't have any problems with this. I think this is definitely one of my favorites out of the line. I think that and the liner, I think they pair beautifully together. But I think I'm having a really good makeup day today. We have two products left to try. We have the highlighter topper, the Miss Neptune highlighter topper. I want to try this so badly. It's like this beautiful purpley iridescent goodness. Now she does have an array of shades on here. Now they're all highlighter toppers, so I know someone was making a video about the green one, but it's every skin tone's different, things suit different skin tones, so don't be put off if a shade doesn't look like for you. It's completely normal. Nothing, not everything's going to suit everyone. Now these are a next level highlighter with a multi-dimensional topper. Okay, so a weightless multi-dimensional topper that can be used on your cheeks, eyes and body, infused with vegetable derived emollients. Our silky creamy powder formula glides on like a second skin, then melts upon application for a dewy luminous highlighter that stays smooth no matter where you wear it. Okay, so this is the purple one. This is the one I've been most excited for. Tiniest amount, literally the tiniest amount on here, and we're just gonna start adding some. This is cute. I feel as if you've got to be very minimal, but I think I should have maybe put another highlighter underneath just to add, these are pigmented, just to add that difference in there. But I feel as if you feel like you've applied too much, you can just obviously go on top. If you've got a powder brush or a foundation brush or one of the two, you can just go on top. But this is lovely. And it's just, it's really cute. It lines well with, like, obviously my foundation stuff. I personally wouldn't apply this to my forehead. I usually apply highlighter to my forehead, but I'm not going to in this. But let me just apply a little bit more. Oh, that's gorgeous. The blend, the purple iridescent feel does sort of go away, but it adds really, really lovely. It's so nice. Don't know what you guys think of that, but I don't think you need to go and then loads on your face. I think that's just what a lot of TikTokers and a lot of Instagram people do. And it's just like, realistically, you're not going to go out wearing that. If you want this to be wearable, you just have to sort of go minimal and build. But I think that's nice. I think they retail for, I think these ones are sold out, but they retail for $22. Is it worth $22? I don't really know. I think it's because I'm not a highlighter girl anymore. I just use my base to glow. But this is cute. I do love, though, that she has a huge shade range of this. Now, I know I should have talked about this on camera before, but I did just apply it onto my lips. It is the R.E.M. Beauty Plumping Lip Gloss. Now, this was sold out, and I don't actually know how much this retails for. But it does have that. I'm starting to have a slight tingling sensation. The lip liner that I went in with was the ColourPop Lippy Pencil in the shade Oh Snap. It's a very, very nice, everyday, basic nude kind of colour. But it's starting to tingle a little bit. It's not as intense as like the lip injection from Too Faced, but at least it's, when it's saying it's plumping, at least I know it's got that tingly feel. It's not like the Maybelline one that says like the Lifter Plumping Lifting Gloss. That doesn't plump at all, well, for me anyway. I like that it's a clear one. because I do want, oh, I can start to feel the tingle now. Basically, yeah, this is a full-ish face, like wise lips and cheek wise of RE/M Beauty. My overall thoughts, I'm pleased with a lot of the stuff. There is some stuff I feel as if, oh my god, yep, it could have improved on. This collection hasn't wowed me. I don't really have anything else to say. I feel as if I've rambled on a lot. I hope you guys have enjoyed this. Let me know if you have any questions in the description. I'll try and link everything because a lot of the stuff that I've been sent has actually been sold out. So yeah, thank you so much for watching this video and I shall see you in my next one. Bye.